So I thought I'd go a little bit abstracty with the card, with the card design paper, the card and the design paper. And this is a four and an eighth by 5 6/7/8 card. And so I'm not going to give you the measurements for it because it will be, you know, just like different wherever you are. This is a card base that I've already bought in. It's not one I've made myself. Because, just because. Got them on special, so I bought them in. So anyway, I thought I'd go a bit abstracty with this card, just to have something different. And I'm using up a design paper pad, making a series of cards on there. So so I've got a few little different shapes and things of cardstock here, not cardstock, design paper here. And so just a little bit abstract for me. I don't normally do this. I'm normally quite a, I normally go, you know, the normal card making rules and things, but I thought I'd just go a little bit different, just for, why not? Why not? So just pop in some layers on the cardstock here, just because we can. Oops. Just because I'm doing it a little bit different doesn't mean to say that I'm not supposed to get it even. So the stamps I'm going to use here are a Rosie Studio one, which I got when I was in New Zealand a little while back. And of course it's a little ballerina one, and I don't know what it's called, but it's a Rosie Studio one. Oh well, I don't know what it's called, because I think I cut off the bit where it said what the stamp was. So there you go. That's the base that I'm working off, and I'm just going to stamp the image out now. So back in a minute. I'm going to use Memento ink to stamp the little ballerina with, because I'm just going to put a few Copics on there. It's really difficult to colour an image as small as this. But we'll place her towards the bottom of this piece of paper, and then we're going to colour it. Also as well with these stamps is a little pair of ballet shoes, so we're just going to pop these on here as well, just at the top of the card there, put one either side. It's a cute little decoration. What it looks like so far. So just simply colouring in. These are very light skin tones on this one. Just going around in the light and dark. This is very difficult as well because the boat is moving. Just put in a little shadows. such a tiny little image that it's, you know, you really don't have to do a lot to it. It's there. Going to give her some nice little lips. Don't want a few darker colour for her lips there. And a bit of pink on her cheeks. After all, she's dancing. She's exerting herself there a little bit. Gonna give her some little pink shoes. Some nice light brown hair. Not really going to do a lot with it, but it's really too small. Maybe we're going to play with two colours here. Put a little bit of pink on the ribbons up here too. And what else am I going to do? Just going to give her a little bit of something to stand on there. Gonna have her hanging in the air. Little bit of shadow around her too, only very lightly, not too much, so it just gives her a bit of dimension off the page. She's got a little white flower in her hair. Okay, and that's what it looks like so far. Okay, so what I'm going to do next is just pop this down onto some cardstock and then pop it onto the card. That's what that looks like. We're going to pop it on the card. Got double-sided tape I've already stuck here. If I showed you me putting the tape on and everything, it would just take forever. Take forever. Just going to pop this on here. What I'm going to do now is to glue her dress, her tutu, in pink onto the body, and then drop it on the card and mark the card, because that's always good, isn't it? It's always a good idea. Like so. And then I've also cut out her little ballet shoes and ribbon and that, so I'll just do the same with that here. Pop a bit of glue on and then stick it on. Just gonna let that dry and then I'll be back for the finishing touches. Okay, so I'm just going to colour in the ribbon just here because I've got and actually go over the other ribbon as well because it's not quite the same, not quite the right colour pink on there. So just going over the ribbon. Then I'm just going to put some shading in the shoes. Don't go too dark. So in the ribbon as well. Just going to put a little bit of colour on the shoe. Because there's a little bow on the shoe as well, the ballet shoe there. So that will just make it pop. she going to do it? Ballet shoes, the same colour down here. Then we're going to pop a little bit of Winker Stella on. It'll be a little bit glittery then. Okay, and that's the card there. I was going to put a sentiment on there, which was, if I can find it. Where did that go? Ah, here it is. Believe in pink. But it doesn't actually go, so I might put it inside, or I might not. But anyway, that's the card for the hashtag event, Think Pink Art, or Love Pink Art. I've forgotten. Oh, I'm so bad, aren't I? Anyway, it's about raising cancer awareness, and the Think Pink is for breast cancer awareness, and it doesn't just affect women, it affects men as well. So feel your boobs. Feel your boobs, and if you have any strange lumps or lumps that you don't recognise or anything, if you have a lump, go and get it checked out. Better to be safe than sorry. So actually, I have decided to add a sentiment to this card and finish off the inside as well. So I'm just using some more of the paper pad. Design paper, and we're just going to pop it inside here, nice and pink, because that's what we're doing. It's all about the pink. So nice and pink, and I'm going to use the believe in, and I'm just going to go around in this marker here. Just going to stick it down here at the corner. And I'm just going to stamp up this stamp. There we go, it says believe in pink. And I'm just going to add a few more embellishments. Just see, look, I'm going to go all out pink now, and I'm going to put some petal pink liquid pearls on here. Was going to, shall I, shan't I? Will I, won't I? We'll see. Anyway, I might be back with some more, who knows? Hope you liked today's card. See you again soon. Bye.